Hi there, in this video, I will share with you what is recursion and how to handle actual recursion questions in the 9618 paper 4 exam. After learning this, you will understand better on what is recursion and the thought process on solving exam questions related to recursion. I'm Chen Ming. This channel is specialized in helping students who are taking A-level computer science. Remember to subscribe and turn on the notification if you are interested to learn more about A-level computer science. First of all, what is recursion? Recursion is a method where the solution to a problem depends on solutions to smaller instances of the same problem. Next, we have components of recursion. For components, basically we have two main components. The first component would be the base case. This is the terminating scenario that does not use recursion to produce an answer. The base case is crucial as it stops the function from calling itself indefinitely and helps prevent a potential infinite loop. So for recursion, base case is very important because for every recursion code that you write, you always need to have a base case or else your recursion will just stuck in this infinite loop. So later on, we'll just show you some example for you to understand better on the base case. The next component will be recursive case. This is the scenario where the function calls itself to perform a simpler version of the original task. In the recursive case, we break the problem down into a simple subproblem or multiple subproblems. Therefore, recursion is basically made up of the base case as well as the recursive case. And lastly, recursion is used extensively in data structures and algorithms, especially when dealing with hierarchical structures like trees and graphs. Understanding recursion can also help improve problem-solving skill and thinking in terms of subproblems, which is essential in dynamic programming. Now let's look at one basic recursive function, which is the Fibonacci series. So what is Fibonacci? Basically, the Fibonacci sequence is a series of numbers where the next number is found by adding up the two numbers before it. And the example will be this one here. For example, 0, 1. So 1 plus 0 is equal to 1. And then 1 plus 1 is equal to 2 and etc. So this is the Fibonacci sequence. And now let's look at the actual Python function. So this will be the Python function here. Definition Fibonacci n. So this function is actually returning the value based on the sequence here. For example, Fibonacci 0 will return 0. Fibonacci 1 will return 1. Fibonacci 2 will return 1. Fibonacci 3 will return 2 and etc. And now let's look at the actual code. If n is less than or equal to 1, we'll return n. Else, return Fibonacci n minus 1 plus Fibonacci n minus 2. So what is the base case for this function? The base case will be this one here. So this will be the base case. It means that let's say n is equal to 0 or 1, it will not run any recursive case. It will just return the base case here. And what is the recursive case? The recursive case is this line here, Fibonacci n minus 1 plus Fibonacci n minus 2. If you look at this, right now, we are calling this Fibonacci function within this Fibonacci function itself. It means that this is actually calling itself, therefore it's a recursive case. And now let's look at one example to understand better. We'll just do a quick walkthrough. For example, when we call Fibonacci 4, the function does not enter the base case because right now, n is actually more than 1. It goes to the recursive case where it will return the sum of Fibonacci 4 minus 1 and Fibonacci 4 minus 2 because n minus 1 and then n minus 2, which means we need to calculate Fibonacci 3 and Fibonacci 2. And to calculate Fibonacci 3, basically it means that it also goes to the recursive case, returning the sum of Fibonacci 3 minus 1 and Fibonacci 3 minus 2, which means we need to calculate Fibonacci 2 and Fibonacci 1. Remember that Fibonacci 1 goes to the base case and returns 1. Next, we'll calculate Fibonacci 2. And to calculate Fibonacci 2, basically it also goes to the recursive case, returning the sum of Fibonacci 2 minus 1 and Fibonacci 2 minus 2. As mentioned before, both Fibonacci 1 and Fibonacci 0 go to the base case and return 1 and 0 respectively. Therefore, Fibonacci 2 is equal to Fibonacci 1 plus Fibonacci 0 is equal to 1 plus 0 is equal to 1. So we are done with Fibonacci 2. And now let's do Fibonacci 3. Therefore, Fibonacci 3 is equal to Fibonacci 2 plus Fibonacci 1, which is equal to this one here, plus 1, which is equal to 2. And lastly, Fibonacci 4 is equal to Fibonacci 3 plus Fibonacci 2, which is equal to 2 plus 1 is equal to 3. Therefore, the final answer is actually equal to 3, which actually match with our example here. For example, 0, 1, 1, 2, 3. And if you look at the index, it's going to be 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. Therefore, F4 is actually equal to 3 here.
And now, let's look at how can we apply the knowledge we learned in the actual past year exam questions.
The following iterative pseudocode function calculates the total of all the values stored in the queue. Function iterative output start as an integer, returns integer. And then declare total is equal to integer. Total is equal to 0 for count start minus 1 to head pointer step minus 1. So for this for loop here, we are doing in a negative manner. Means that we are starting from a big number all the way to the small number. In general, we always start from small number to the big number. But this pseudocode is a bit special. And then total is equal to total plus q, and then count bracket here, next count return total, and then m function. So for this function here, basically you are adding all the numbers starting from the end all the way to the start here, and then rewrite the function as a recursive function using program code. So this is quite a tricky question. We have to understand the logic first in order to write the recursive function. So first of all, let's look at this iterative output function here. So let me just get my pen here and let's just do some drawing here. First of all, let's just give an example of three number. For example, for this array here, we have like 100 elements. But let's just do for the first three, which is 1, 2, and 3. So based on this code here, in order to get a sum of 3 plus 2 plus 1, which is 6 here, we'll put the start as 3 here. And then based on this loop here, it will be 2 to 0. Because head pointer, we are assuming starting from 0 here. So this is 0 here. So it will be running this loop from 2, and then 1, and then comma, and then 0 here. So this is based on the pseudocode here. And because the index is always 0, 1, and 2. So these are the index. So let me just put a bracket here. And now let's try to go through this code one by one. So first of all, what do you do? Total, okay. So total is equal to total plus q. Let me just write q here. And then the first number will be 2 here. So this is for the first iteration. And next will be total is equal to total plus q 1 here. And then finally, total is equal to total plus q 0 here. So for recursive case, the most important thing is figure out the base case. So for this question here, it's obvious that this is the base case here, which is this q 0 here. So this should be the base case here. Which means later on, most probably I can write something like this. If start is equal to 0, I can just return q 0 here. Something like that. So this should be the base case for the recursive. And then if you look at this, what is happening here is basically q2 plus q1 plus q0. So if I draw it out this way, so it should be total is actually equal to q2 plus q1 plus q0 with this as the base case, which means q2 plus q1, this one is the recursive case. And then q1 plus q0, so let me just draw it here. This is also a recursive case. So after understanding how to convert this iterative to recursive case, we can start writing our code with this in mind. We have this base case here. And then most probably for the recursive case, we are just doing like q the index plus the q index minus 1, because q2 plus q1 is basically just q index plus q index minus 1. And then q1 is actually equal to q index plus q index minus 1. So this should be the recursive case. And now let's look at the tips or the prompts here. First of all,
the most important thing for recursive is identify the base case plus the recursive case. So as I show here, this Q0, which is at the bottom of the case, therefore base case is start is equal to 0. And lastly, recursive case is Q start plus function start minus 1. So look at this right now. The recursive case is basically just Q2 plus Q1 and then Q1 plus Q0. So this is the recursive case. And now with this tip or prompt, you can start writing out the recursive function. So I can just say definition, since a verb is iterative output, let me just write recursive output here, and then I can just copy this start here. So this will be my input parameter, and then we will start from the base case. So the base case is start is equal to 0. So if start is equal to 0, then return Q and then just bracket start here. So this is the base case here. And then for the recursive case, it will be just else return Q and then start here. So it will be the value right now and then plus the function name. So what's the function name? It's going to be recursive output. And what will be the input parameter? So based on this example, it will be Q start here and then plus Q start minus 1. Therefore, start minus 1. Therefore, this is the full code for this recursive function here. The most important thing is you have to understand how it works first and then break down into the base case and recursive case first. Then you can derive the solution.
And there you have it. We started from what is recursion and then look at the famous Fibonacci series using recursion. After understanding the basics, we look at how to convert an iterative pseudocode function into an actual Python recursive function from a past year exam question. I hope you will be able to solve recursion question on your own if you face it in the near future. At the same time, I have also recorded a free webinar whereby I talk about the best strategies to ace the 9618 paper 4 exam, and the link is in the description and the comment section below. Thank you, and I will see you again then. Bye bye.